Michael Padilla at Renzo Gracie, Pennsylvania. Again, big on the local circuit. He's going to be up against Rob Mudrak. Rob Mudrak actually is with East Coast MMA, Team Balance. Both these guys, again, man, seasoned competitors. Both brown belts. Mudrak actually runs Nextgen MMA. Rob Mudrak is a big 180 pounds. He is a big 180 pounds. You'll see when he gets into the ring.
Who's this?
He is a, Rob
this
Mudrak.
Is, who's up?
Rob Mudrak. This is him walking in the ring. Now he's taking off the...
In the gray?
Sir, in the gray. He is a very large 180 pound fighter. Again, another seasoned, very seasoned competitor in the local circuit.
Wasn't this one of the fighters from the last time we...
No, none of these guys are returning yet. The only returning guys are Bill Algio, Matt Doss.
Oh, my God.
He's a big 180.
He's big. He's actually bigger than Elias.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And has the body.
He's taller and
has the size.
He's a big, strong, technical guy.
Good.
Fight.
All right, round one underway. A lot of the stuff I've seen Mudrak do, he does like to pull half guard. Don't know what he'll do being the larger, stronger person here. Whether he's going to be looking to take down and get on top. Wow, and actually, Padilla goes right for the takedown. Again, this isn't a spot that Mudrak is uncomfortable in at all. Been here before. Padilla doing a really good job controlling from that top position. Notice he's staying completely away from his hips, how he's staying in that north-south type position. He's trying to avoid exactly that, him getting to some kind of guard. Mudrak stands right back up. Nice takedown. Good deep shot. Again, Padilla, man, he's got a very, very quick single leg. Man, that's the second one he's gotten already. But again, Mudrak, he's very good with leg locks, very good with ankle locks. And as I say that, Padilla goes for that ankle lock, and it's in tight. Mudrak doing a good job defending. He's looking for his own foot lock. He was looking for heel hook, and he might have it. And he got Padilla fighting his hand. Now he's doing a good job of defending that there. Padilla. See how flexible Padilla is as well. Yeah, these guys both good at leg locks. Most of the footage I've seen of Mudrak, he is finishing in leg locks. Halfway through this round. Still spinning for that leg, spinning for that heel hook. Halfway through the first. In 50-50 guard right now. That's where both their legs, same leg, entangling between each other. It's pretty much a sweeper submission position with this 50-50 guard. Again, both I still fighting for a leg lock. We're under a minute here. I think Padilla is more looking to try to get out of this position, where I think Rob is trying to use this position to get to that heel hook because he's got his leg draped across his hips.
Now I notice Rob has a sleeve over the knee. You know,
yep, that could be either. And again, he's looking for that knee bar. Now he's trying to turn it to heel hook. He's got the legs crossed. Yeah, that could either be. That could be for two things. That could be for grip. Or it could be for he has a knee that he's trying to take care of. Ten seconds left.
I'm almost wondering, is he
time?
Yeah, I'm almost wondering if he's trying to get out of it, or is he going after that?
You know what? The thing is, that position is actually a particular guard called a 50-50 guard, where
you're both in the same exact position where you both have your same side leg entangled, and that's it. So the only person who has the advantage in the position is the guy who's up. That's the guy who would get the points. This isn't about the points in this competition, though. This is about the... trying to win the round, trying to get the submission. So just because Rob was on the bottom, again, doesn't mean he was actually losing, although the two takedowns definitely didn't help him. He was doing a great job of trying to go for them leg locks. All right, round two underway. And but this time Mudrak jumps to guard, and he ends up getting the leg over top, both legs over top, which you'll see Padilla's going to try to lift. Oh, great pass by Padilla. Great pass. Rob doing a good job trying to get that leg over just to push him away enough to get back to a guard. He keeps trapping an arm, though. Padilla's doing a real good job staying where he needs to be, staying in control in that top position. So we got Mudrak down in the guard position right now. Padilla on top. So Padilla looking to try to pass there. Gets that knee through the hole. Now he's going to try to pick a side. Oh, just pulls the leg out. Back to their feet. Hanging heavy on that head. Let's see what happens here. Padilla's got a great single leg. Oh, went to throw. Oh, and man, nice. Rob's going to end up on top of Padilla right for that leg lock, man. That quick. They're right back into this 50-50 guard position. Again, both of them are going to be fighting for a leg lock or that top position.
Now, on that move, mm-hmm. I mean, should Rob have went on top instead of going for the leg lock?
No, because he'd have to be on the bottom to get that particular leg lock. What he's trying to do is trying to hook the heel and turn it in, which actually puts pressure on the knee and the tendons going to the knee. Not even many tournaments are allowed to actually do that submission unless you're in the most advanced divisions. Obviously here everything is legal, neck cranks and all that. Now Padilla tried to roll for a knee bar. Rob did a good job following him right over top, and now he's almost taking a back position. He's going to end up on top in half guard. Padilla immediately starts working. Padilla looks fine from that half guard position too. He's going to get the leg out. Looking to go, looks like a rubber guard position where he's pulling that leg all the way up. Mudrak pops his head right out.
I still want to see you working, Rob. 45.
Rob kind of stuck right down Padilla's guard, trying to push down Padilla. Padilla's staying tight in that position. Less than 30 seconds left, and he's moving. He's trying to move for another leg lock. I can't really see what he's going for here. Looks like another heel hook. He gets the tap. Mudrak attacks them legs. That's what he does best. And great match, man. Excellent match. A lot more submissions.
Unbelievable.
So now we have the semifinal set up. And we're looking at Gary Tan and Juan Vasquez, and then Steve Wilson, Rob Mudrak. We do have the super fight coming up with John Battle and Zach Green. These matches have been great so far, man. I'm really enjoying these matches. And again, you can't beat the seats. You can't beat the seats.
No, definitely not.
Give it up for guys.